There we go. And I should pin myself. Better spotlight. All right. Okay. Here we go. My name's Kelly. Welcome. I guess you don't need to see so much of the ceiling. And we're going to start off first just doing a chair pose and then trunk flexion, just to one side, a lateral flexion, and then chair and other side. Just nice deep breaths. You're like me. I was sitting a lot this morning. Actually, I stood at my desk here, but just haven't really moved. So let's ease into it. Go to your own range. Nice deep breaths. Let's go one more time each side. And we're going to do a hip opener. So right knee up and open, and then left knee up and open. Just little hip openers. Our first exercise today is cross country skiing. I'll show variations, but want to get those hips opened and get that mobility for safer exercises today. All right, and let's do one more each side. And we'll bring it to high knees. You could either reach out if you want to keep those arms down below shoulders, or you can reach up if you feel okay. And you can go higher or lower, or you can march it out. Just warming it up, getting those glutes engaged. Start getting that blood flowing through, increase that heart rate. It's a fairly short workout today, but you'll realize how hard you can work and how much you can get done in a short amount of time. So it's a nice option when you're short on time. All right, and let's kick it out. Straight arm, straight leg, opposite. Just try and keep your torso up. Try not to lean forward. Reach that leg. Okay, if you can't kick high or touch the leg, we're getting that glute hamstring now. Good. You got it. I always like to get that lateral motion since we tend to walk and move in a frontal plane all the time. So let's go side to side in 4, 3, 2, 1, side to side, soft knees out wide. Keep pumping the arms, abs tight. Always practicing those shoulders back and down. Oh, sounds like a very close Super Bowl game yesterday. I went to bed after Usher, after halftime, or shortly after. Not right away, but I always just want a good game, although I wasn't bested on who won. And hamstring curl, last part, just to stretch out those quads. You can reach up or forward. Nice deep breaths. They say the average person consumes over 8,000 calories on Super Bowl Sunday. I suppose all the cheese dips. All right, and release. Take a deep breath up. But you know, it's what you do the majority of the time. One day is not going to make or break you. So thanks for joining in today. And let's get started. Okay, so we are, the first one is cross country ski. It's going to be 6 cycles of 20 seconds on, 10 second recovery. You go at your own pace. So before I start the clock, you can always tap that right foot back, right arm forward, left foot. So it could just be tap. You could do a, more of a shuffle, a little slide, or you could really sprawl out. And you could change every time, but just let's focus on the first 20 seconds. It'll be a total of 3 minutes, and we'll get going. So getting into those cross country skis, 3, 2, 1, and go. You can tap there or slide. There are live free apps where you can set timers. I'll share that with you when I share the video. It's a good one to be mindless. but still stay true to form. You can, and release. All right, and you can always keep those shoulders down as you go. You don't have to reach up high if that no lash rotator issue is going on. All right, round two, go. So just here, you can tap back, add a little bounce, a little shuffle, or really stretch out. Good. Keep the core engaged, navel tight to the spine. You can do it. 3, 2, 1, and release. Take a couple deep breaths. Get that oxygen to those muscles. Fuel round three. Ready and go. Round three. Excellent work, team. So nice tight core, working across opposite arm, leg, coming forward or back. Really helps cognition as well. And release. All right, we're at the halfway mark. Three down, three to go. All right, and let's do it, go. Just focus on the gain through the next 20 seconds. If you're feeling good, you can go a little faster or increase that range of motion. You go at your own pace, push yourself to your limit. There's no competition, and release. You guys, we're over the hump. Four down, two to go. All right, Laura, join in. Nice to have you. And go. Breathe through it. Good, push those arms back. Keeping those knees soft. Want a little extra, engage those glutes. 3, 2, 1, and release. One more. Cycle of 20, and then we are done with cross-country skiers. All good things must come to an end. Begin. Final 20 of this exercise. Terrific. I don't know if these Bluetooth speakers for computers were meant for teaching when you're jumping around. 3, 2, all the way through, and release it. All right. So now you've experienced a modified Tabata, 6 rounds instead of 8. And we're gonna be doing that same format, the 6 rounds of 20 seconds, 10 second break for every exercise today. So the next one is dumbbell swing. Yeah, now if you remember where you're doing that squat and you can reach out, if you don't want to use the weight, bad back, or right in here, or if you prefer and just want to do squats with or without weights, you can do that as well. Otherwise, it's that one weight, bag, whatever you have, that heavy, head up, chest up, and then using those hips to push forward. The arms are always just along for the ride on this one. So you pick with or without a weight, basic squat with or without a weight, or those swings. We got 6 rounds. All right, one more deep breath. Get the weight up. I'm using my phone as a timer. So ready, set, go. So I can't quite do that first rep with you. There, go back and up. Remember this one, you're looking up. That way you bend the knees, head up over heart. And that also protects that low back. All right, and release. So we got that 5 more times. We can go a little more range of motion as we get going here. All right, and go. Use those hips to drive that weight forward. And the dumbbell just goes wherever it goes. So you're not using those arms to push that dumbbell up. It's the hips, just getting that momentum. Abs tight and release. 2 down, feel free, a little shake out. Excellent. I really like this format, and go, because you could pick any exercise. It kind of pushes you without, you just have to pick your own exercise and the timer tells you when to go and stop. Excellent. And I'm saying, get those glutes. Push those hips. And release. All right. We're at the halfway mark already. Time flies when you're doing swings. Weight up, head up, and go. Exhale up. Terrific. Nice job. Know you're pushing hard. Wendy Ann. We got Christine on here. Laura. Awesome work. We're four down, two to go. All right, we got Diane and Sarah as well. And oh, we got Christine and Kristen. Go. There you go. Use those legs. Make this your best round yet. Every rep counts. You got it. Soft knees. It's a great one. Don't really feel all that strength, like the burn of a lift decrease. Feels kind of like a flow, but it gets the whole back area. All right, last round. Stay true to form and go. You're like me. Last week, I felt it all the way through my backside. And there's so much with the ball curl for those hamstrings and this. Push-ups. You got it. Three, two, and awesome work, team. All right, we're done with the weight today. Go ahead, take a deep breath, take some water as I demonstrate the next one. So it's mountain climbers. I'm gonna do alternating. I'm gonna do one round of high knees, one round of mountain climbers. If you want, you can stay in that mountain climber the whole time or high knees. So with high knees, I'm gonna run like high knees, but you can always go right here, kind of what we did with that warm up there. And then with mountain climbers, every other round I'm gonna do a mountain climber. It's soft knees and it's pulling that knee in without tapping that toe forward, but you can stay high knees, or if you have a chair, a bed, a bench, you can be more upright, and that'll make it a little easier on the up. Thank you. going into push-ups. There we go. Mountain climbers. My dad has the old Nordic track. He could do it. If you have an old Nordic track, you could do it. 4, 3, 2, and release it. All right. What's nice is we don't have push-ups yet. It's nice going from that plank, not having planks right away. So next we are going into squat jumps or fast feet. So again, I'll do both. And you could pick any cardio. So if you want to be doing jacks or if you want to do fire hydrants, you could do any activity. But this is going to be a cardio one again. So I'm going to start out with fast feet, just right in there. And then every other round, it's squat hops. For those that want to go, you could always just go there. Or you could stick with the fast feet the whole time, especially if you have bad knees, don't want to jump, or depending where you're at, if you don't have much padding. So I'm going to alternate fast feet, squat jumps. But you could do fast feet the entire time or squat jumps the entire time or your own thing. You could tap out jacks. All right. So after this round, we do have push-ups or planks. So we'll get our heart rate down a little bit. All right. Ready, set, and go. So with the fast feet, abs are tight. Just keep the heels up, engage those calves, and find that inner football player. And as I do this, I try to tighten up my legs, my glutes. It's still going to be jiggly, I know, but you can intrinsically contract to help that and just get that more muscle recruitment. All right, you can stick with that, or you can do little hops if you want, or squat hops. Go. So this is more power, but you could always be down and up or little hops. Pull through. Just keep that head up, chest up. 5 seconds. And release it. Awesome work. Don't feel bad about whatever you're doing. If you're modifying, go. You're working out and you're here. That just want to keep that body moving. Doing more than just sitting at your desk. So there's a win. And every person is different with ailments. So you want to work yourself without injury. Release. A squat jump's not worth it if you have bad knees or back. Don't do it. All right, go. 3 down, 3 rounds to go. Always keeping that head up, chest up, above heart. Duck that back as well. Can't say that enough, as you can tell. And release. Between that and shoulders back and down, you just have that kind of continuous loop. All right, we have 2 more rounds, team. Fast feet or your exercise. Go wider, get a little deeper, or you can bring it up. Yeah, bad back. Bring it up to protect. You can go out, you can move around. Keep the abs tight. Pull those elbows in. There you go. 3, 2, 1, and we have 1 last one. Couple more deep breaths. Last 20 seconds, go. Let's make a commitment to going through all the way past the beep. Continuous. 8 more seconds. Not stopping before that finish line or at it.
Thank you.
Shoulders inward towards that sternum, getting the chest. 8 seconds. Breathe through it. And recover. All right. Fitness transformation challengers. We have our last exercise. It's going to be reverse lunge. So this is your choice. You can do with weights or without weights and do that reverse lunge alternating. Now, if that bothers your leg, I would do knee repeater or back and up and do all 20 seconds and then just keep switching legs. And then the other time you could do either knee repeater or there. And then the other option is without weights, and it's almost like that ski, but it's that lunge hop. I call it a flunge because it's fun lunges, but maybe it's not so fun. Maybe the F is for something else. So I will go with one set of reverse lunges. I'll use weights, and then every other set I'll do the flunges. But there's so many options. Again, pay attention if you have a bad back, that knee repeater if you want cardio, or you could be there and just tap and hold weight, a little strength, however you want. Just make sure you get three on each side if you're switching it up or just doing one leg. This is our last 3 minutes before we do our stretch. All right, ready, set, and move. If you have weights, just keep the arms back and down. You try and get as many reps as you can in those 20 seconds while being mindful of form. And release. You can set the weights down if you like, or go the other side. I'm going to do those lunges. And go. You can do knee repeaters. Do anything. Keep that body moving. Nice work. 6 seconds. And release. All right. 2 rounds down. 4 to go. Nothing you can't handle. Go. Yeah, so this, obviously, every fourth week is going to be more of a cardio focus. That's, and next week we'll get back to strength instead of endurance, muscular endurance. The focus will be perhaps on strength. It'll be different, some different weight exercises for next week. All right, go. 3 rounds down, 3 to go. Way to push yourselves. Way to keep moving. Bring in that energy. You got it.
Thank you.
through that low back, hip. Release, interlace the fingers, push forward towards me. Soft knees as you're pushing towards that computer, push the hips back. Keep pushing forward. Head stays just slightly above that heart and let the arms just dangle. Good. Flick out the fingers or the wrists. You can roll those hands, wrists. And then just light slide, stretch side to side. Let's bring up the one heel. Good. Now just stay towards that left. You can be more upright. You don't have to be deep, or you can be deep. Bring the toes up on that right side. Lean to that left, glutes out. And just reach for that right foot. It can be right here, or you can slide down, your choice. Or reach for that toe. Good. Take a deep breath up. And exhale, lean to that right. Glutes out, head up. And left toes up. And hold there, you could sink deeper. Nice deep breaths. And let's take two big deep breaths in. Bring in the energy, release any tightness, tension, and give yourself a pat on the back. You all did so awesome. Way to make it through HIIT. Next week's a different workout. We're back to more weight. It'll be a different workout, so I'll send that to you. Thank you so much. Oh, Rhonda, I didn't even see you. I'm so sorry. I didn't even see you on here.